Wales in 1988, the Manic Street Preachers brought back British rock with attitude. Designed for Life is the first song the Manics have released since the disappearance of guitarist Richie James Edwards 15 months ago. It is taken from the new album Everything Must Go, which is released next week. The band have dedicated the album to Richie and their former manager Philip Hall, who sadly died of cancer. The Manics are well known for tackling social and political issues. Their songs are always full of emotion, and Design for Life is no exception. A rock ballad of mammoth scale, Design for Life has brought the Manic Street Preachers back to the top, so join them today as they hang out with us.
Now they have actually just let me in the studio.
Yay!
Because, thank you very much, because I was so excited about the Manic Street Preachers that they had to hold me back because I threatened to stage dive it. So here I am now, and I'm actually sitting next to James from the Manic Street. So good day to you.
Good to meet you, Captain.
And thank you very much for that performance, because it was pretty blinding.
Now,
yes. Two rounds of applause. Now, James, could you just tell me about the video for Design for Life? Because it seems quite meaningful, and as you know, I'm very thick and I didn't quite get it.
Just basically, it's just like the juxtaposition, big word, of just working class imagery and kind of like almost quite cliche kind of like, you know, Apple Mobile like class imagery, you know, just kind of get a point across because it's a positive song about working classes.
And do you think some of the best songs in Britain, which has a very healthy music scene, has come from the working class?
Probably the best frontman since John Lydon, you know, Liam, you know, you can't get much more salt of the earth than Liam, so yes, I suppose the answer is yes, really.
And that's happened over the ages, hasn't it?
Aye, to be sure, lad.
Well, thank you very much. Now, is there an actual a meaning to that song, Design for Life?
Yes.
I mean, the video has the juxtaposition of the class thing, but is there a meaning in the song?
Yeah, it's just like a reaffirmation of, like, you know, of working class values, basically. It just says, wherever you check the working classes, they'll always have their own language, and they'll always have their own culture, and, like, you know, they'll always have their own geniuses, you know, whether it be Liam or Ryan Giggs, or, like, Sean Ryder, you know. It's just basically like, you know, reiterating that. It's just a rejection of values and a reaffirmation of working class values.
A reaffirmation of what you stand for.
Aye.
Well,
can
top
I
one.
Ask a question?
Yeah, go on.
Sorry. Who directed the video?
A bloke called Pedro. He did Common People.
Okay.
And he did a lot of Paul Weller videos. He's a cool looking fella. Wears tank tops.
Now, thank you.
Now listen, you can speak to this man. The numbers should be flashing up on your screen. And I think you should, because he's got a lot to say. But someone else who has a lot to say is Jordan Dingley. But I've got good news. They're on again, performing live and exclusively at the end of the show. So stay tuned for that. Now, also, what are these odd things in my lap? Firstly, we have signed copies of the album, Everything Must Go, signed. If you call in, ask a decent question, you can win these. We've got T-shirts. Extremely fashionable and really rather devilish, you can win these.
Ooh.
So stay tuned for that. Now, James, you just performed in Main Road with Oasis,
yeah.
Manchester City's football ground, and I was there. It was pretty amazing for me. Yeah. How was it for you?
Woof. Well, it was okay. It's kind of like, at the end of the day, it was Oasis's gig, you know. Mm. So, like, kind of like, you're not going to enjoy it as much because it's their gig and, like, you want it's their day to enjoy, you know, basically. But it was brilliant, you know, they treated us really well and the crowd were very charitable.
They were brilliant.
Yes, but it was kind of like, it was nice to get a bit of fresh air in my lungs.
Brilliant.
While I was doing my job.
In a proper football stadium as well.
Well, steady on.
Well, but, for me, we'll move along from that swiftly. For me, it was a legendary concert and you and Oasis were pretty blinding, as I said. Now, we'll be speaking to this man later in the show, but first...
And we've been saying that you can ask James some interesting questions. We're going to make it a little bit interesting today. Anybody that asks an interesting or an intelligent question, because we don't get many of those, namely from me, on the show, you get a special T-shirt. And I notice you've got some little T-shirts for girlies. I like these a lot. I might have to sort of take one of those for myself. just fit over that ample chest of mine. And a CD. So interesting questions, please. I do believe we're going to go to a phone call first from Jennifer in Ireland. Jennifer?
Hello.
Hi, Jennifer. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. How are you doing?
I'm grand. How are you?
I'm all right. So what would you like to ask James?
How do you feel about the new Welsh bands like Gorky's Iconic Monkey and Super Furry Animals writing in Welsh? Did you ever feel compelled to write in Welsh yourself?
No, not really. I mean, Gorky's writing Welsh because, you know, for a lot of Gorky's, you know, and Super Furry Animals, even though they don't really sing in Welsh, kind of for them, Welsh is a first language for them, and it's not for us.
Do you speak Welsh?
Just like, you know, fish and chips, stuff like that, but nothing else, you know.
Say fish and chips in Welsh. Go on.
Yeah, right.
Go.
Racist.
No, I'm not at all.
But, you know, there's no point saying a language that you don't really understand. Shut up. Answer my question. There's no point saying a language you don't understand that much. We're anglicised Welsh, and like they're proper hardcore Welsh.
So you're quite a nationalist then. But you live in London.
We are becoming the first republic. We are.
But yes. you live in London though, don't you?
Yeah, but I'm cultural attaché for Wales.
What do you think? What's your connection with Wales?
Oh, I just love the bands from Wales. They're brilliant.
There you go.
Well, thank you, love.
That's a compliment. Okay, thanks very much, Jennifer. If we'd like to go to the next caller. I'm in trouble here with James. He doesn't like me anymore. Daniel?
Yeah, hello.
Hi, Daniel. You're calling from Germany?
Yeah, from Germany.
What would you like to ask James?
Yeah, I want to ask him if he's going to play some gigs in Germany after summer.
Are you?
Yeah, in June we're playing Cologne and Frankfurt, I think.
Where do you live?
Playing
Cologne. I live in a small village. It's not near Cologne.
Can you get to Cologne?
Or Frankfurt, huh? I hate my town and I want...
Oh, dear, that's awful.
Yeah.
We're doing some kind of festival.
I want to ask him if he's playing...
What else would you like to ask?
Yeah, playing a live gig with the Oasis. I've heard it before and... do you like Noel or Liam? I'm sorry about this, not too intelligent questions. But
no, sweetheart, don't worry. That was a fine question and you can definitely still get your T-shirt.
Yeah.
Oh, look, he's all in a dither because he doesn't think... Yeah, that was a fine question. Yeah, and also, Jennifer, if you're still watching, you get one as well. Now, I've got a really nice one here. Someone here called Sherry got an advanced copy of the album Everything Must Go, which it has to be said is a wonderful work of art. Yay!
Yay!
Okay, now, she loves the song Australia. Have you ever thought of escaping to somewhere like Australia to get away from everything? Do you always see yourself living in England?
I've kind of had a bit of a dream of escaping to Newfoundland. I've always seen myself as a bit of a woolly fisher kind of thing.
So you'd give up the music and stuff. Would you ever do that? No, you'd have to.
Six months or so. That's more Nick's kind of vibe. It's kind of like this.
So you might be a woolly fisher. Mm. And also, dear James, will you ever perform any of the Generation Terrorist songs live again from Katie and Louise?
Yeah, we'll be playing songs like You Love Us and Motorcycle Emptiness.
Well, they said...
Remember them still.
See you at the forum.
Ah, we'll see you there
so
too.
They'll see you there. Okay, right now, let's go to a video. Thank you very much, James. Big round of applause for James. Yay! And here's the